Let us now reproduce the results in the teaching evaluation study. Our task is to reproduce this table. Note that some of the statistics are estimated or calculated using weighted data. We will now start by replicating these results in SPSS. The first task is to weight the data set by number of students. To accomplish this, we'll click on Data, click on Weight Cases, and then select Students as the weighting option. We'll click Weight Cases By, and then Students, and then click on OK. SPSS will now treat all observations as weighted observations. Let us now compute the average teaching evaluations using weighted data. So we'll click on Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, click on Descriptives, and the teaching evaluation score is there. Click on this, and we click on Options to determine if the mean and standard deviations are selected, and they are. Click on Continue, and then click on OK, and the results are reported in the output window. The average teaching evaluation is 4.02, and the standard deviation is 0.52. These are weighted statistics. We return to the table to see if the statistics reported in the paper are the same as we have computed, and we find them to be the same. To turn the weighting off, we click on Data, click on Weight Cases, and say Do Not Weight Cases, click on OK, and then re-estimate the mean and standard deviation. And you can see that the results are slightly different. Instead of 4.02, we now get 3.99, and instead of 0.52 in the weighted case, we get 0.55 in the non-weighted case. To compute percent evaluating, we click on Transform, Compute Variable, and type the name, percentage eval, and then click on Students, then divided by all students times 100. Click OK, and the variable is created. Once the variable is created, we can type percent evaluating as the label so that when we produce statistics, it will show the label instead of the name. Also note that when we calculated this variable, I had already deselected the weighting option. With weights being off, we click on Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Descriptives, select percent evaluating, and also select number of all students and click here. Now these two variables are selected. We click on OK. The results are presented here. Percent evaluating is 74.42 with a standard deviation of 16.75, and average number of students is 55.18 with a standard deviation of 75.07, and this matches the statistics reported in the paper. I will now turn the weighting option on. Weight cases by students, click OK, and then go into Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Frequencies, and compute the frequencies for these four variables. Click OK. 35.9% instructors were female, 9.9% instructors were minority, 3.7% instructors were non-native speakers of English language, and 85.1% instructors were tenured professors. Again, these four statistics match the numbers reported in the paper. I turn the weights option off again. So data, weight cases, do not weight cases, and click on OK, and then analyze descriptive statistics frequencies and reset the dialog box. I select division and compute the frequencies. 33.9% courses were lower division courses. Again, this number matches the statistics reported in the paper. Also note that the total number of courses were 463, and the last thing to accomplish is to determine the unique number of faculty members who taught the courses. For this, we click on Data, Identify Duplicates, and a new dialog box opens. We select Prof to define matching cases, and then it will create a new variable, primary last one, and we select OK. The next step is to filter data. So we go back to Data, select cases, and say if condition is satisfied, click on If. We click on primary last one, and say equals to 1 and click continue, and then say filter out unselected cases. So for cases where primary last equals 0, it will be filtered out. Click on OK. When we return to the data, we see that a diagonal line crosses out all the unselected observations. To determine the number of faculty members that are unique, we click on Analyze, Reports, or Descriptive Statistics, and click on Descriptives. And doesn't matter what variables we select, we click on OK. And the number of unique cases are 94, which is exactly the same as in the paper. Notice that we have essentially reproduced all the statistics in the paper in Table 1 under all observations.